big rivalry tonight.
In the state championship game, the third time it's happened, and we're going to talk about that in just a minute. Of course, everybody's been asking me all week who's going to win, and I don't tell them because I don't want to get anybody mad at me. We're going to talk about that in a minute. First, the Electric Ball Championship will be decided at Memorial Stadium between Great Falls High and CMR. Tonight's game will also be a classic matchup between the state's top two teams. The number one rated Westwood is entering the game unbeaten and 11-0. Bison are 9-2, finished second in the regular season rankings. Great Falls High and CMR have played 22 games combined as they head into tonight's contest, but only two games have been on their minds this week, tonight's and their meeting of 2 weeks ago. Jack Johnson's Rustlers demolished the Bison that night, rolling to a 27-0 win. They dominated both sides of the football, running up 340 yards on offense and holding Great Falls High to 111. The task for the Bison tonight is to simply play better.
We have to mainly correct the mistakes that we've made. We made some key mistakes as far as turnovers. You know, Kurt threw four interceptions, and we had a couple of missed blocks and stuff. I think the game could have gone either way, you know, with a few of the mistakes corrected.
We're going to have to do a lot of things differently than we did. We didn't see more the last time. We got to stop their rush. We got to play well on defense, and that's supposed to be the two big keys.
I think the pressure is off us a little bit now. You know, CMR still undefeated and still trying to win the state championship and go undefeated. And, you know, for us, we got to show up and play. And I think our kids will be a little looser, and I don't think we'll make the same mistakes we made. If we do, we're going to be in big trouble. CMR is an excellent football team. But we just need to eliminate mental mistakes and hopefully play a little better on both sides of the ball. And I think we've got to be a little more aggressive up in the front. I thought Russell beat us off the ball offensively and defensively, and, you know, we're not going to win if we let that happen again.
CMR made it look easy 2 weeks ago, but they know the Bison will be fired up tonight. And they should play a lot better with the state title on the line.
That game, you know, a lot of things change, you know, then and now, and I think it's going to take another great effort by our kids to beat them in the game right now. I would doubt that we'd be able to be that successful as we were the first time. You know, we were pretty dominant that first time, but I'm sure they're going to make some adjustments, and it'll be harder, I think, this time around.
We're going to have a pretty good hustle out of everybody, and I think we're going to have to get really psyched up for the game because I don't think they're going to be as bad as they were on the first play.
I think whoever controls the line of scrimmage has got the advantage, and, you know, our offensive line and defensive line have been working hard, and they've controlled the line of scrimmage in just about every game we've played, and that's why we've been successful.
No matter who wins tonight, Great Falls teams will share 7 state football titles in the 80s, the most by any city in the AA ranks in this decade.
Great Falls is a good football town. Both schools here, both high schools play good football, and I think, you know, this is a tribute to that. Third time that we've played it in this decade. Best football, I feel, is played here at Great Falls for the most part.
The city can be proud of both schools and both programs, and, you know, they demand good football in Great Falls, and I think these two teams on both sides of town exemplify, you know, the excellent football that's played in Montana, and it's really nice, I think, for the city that both of them can play for this championship.
First, the game kicks off at 7:30, and Alex said I'm not going to commit to either team because half the time will hate me and the other half will like me, and I could be wrong.
It's obvious. Of course, I'm not going to say anything either. We'll be right back.
Playing them for the state championship, so I think it speaks well of football played by the two schools here in Great Falls.
The weather, Ron tells us, is supposed to cooperate. Kickoff is set for 7:30.
Tickets, how many are sold? How many do you expect to have in the house?
There were some reserve seats, some good reserve seats left at 3 o'clock this afternoon, Ron, so I think that someone who desires one could walk up and get a good seat. We've advanced sales to the students, so I think you can get a good general admission ticket without having to stand in line for any great period of time. I don't anticipate at this point a sellout if advanced sales are any indication. We'll have a great crowd, but I don't think it'll be quite as full as...
Mitch Mackey, Tony Arson, Dan Bluskin, Gary Lowry, and Gary Stepman, the trainer, Wiley Kendall. Now for tonight's starting lineups, first of all for the defending AA champions from Great Falls High School, the defensive unit. Starting at left end, the junior, number 69, Johansi Manzanares. At left tackle, a junior, number 67, Paul Weir. At right tackle, a senior, number 74, Pete Harris. Now the starting lineup for the AA Conference champion, the CMR Wrestlers. pitcher, Daryl Kajala. At the guards, number 68, a senior, Justin Robbins. Down to about the 32. Hand off to Keeler. Hand off to Keeler. Dickinson on the keeper. Dickinson hands to Curtiser. Paul Ware on the stop for the bunny. by Andy Rook. On the stop for the wrestlers.
Got it ready!
More hands off to Matt Woody. Knutson and Green on the stop. Loss on the play. Brings up third and about eight. And off to Dennis Audette. You sure? Tackled by Dawson to the wrestlers.
You were a rookie, boy.
Hand off to Audette.
Audette's running harder.
Zach Mews on the stop for the wrestlers. Pass to Mike Johnson. Klinger's kick rolls out of bounds.
Oh, come on,
Dickinson, pass.
They've been getting pretty good. Yeah.
Hand off to Keeler. Hand off to Gerter, sir. Hand off to Gerter, sir. Good for the first down. Dickinson keeps. Dickinson hands off to Keeler.
Blew him off there.
By Ware of the Bison, good for the first down. Pass falls incomplete. Dickinson keeps. Thank you. interception. Al had fumbled but recovers. Bison take over. Thorn pitches draw dead on the left side.
But, Michael, it didn't work. It doesn't polish.
John Knudsen on the stop for the rustler.
No, John. Yeah. I figured no Knudsen go over the other side of the river.
No.
Thorn's pass to Fred Hensley complete. Thorn pitches to Dennis Audette.
I wish he did.
Genius on the tackle for the rustler.
Should I have him in the backfield? Come on, get him!
Into rustler territory.
Come on, knock it. Pass.
Pitch to a net. And Green on the stop. Side. service here. We're on the left side.
Let's go, Dave!
Somebody's really into it, Dave. Good job!
Pass to Keeler, complete. Forced out of bounds.
He put the hurt on it. Pick it, Bryson.
Hand off to Keeler. Dickinson to McElroy, complete. Kim Klinger on the tackle for the Bison. Ball.
They did pull it.
There you go.
And up, Mr. Gritter, sir.
Flintstone. He's got to stop.
Second and goal at the five.
Let's go.
Dig in. Dig in. Dig in.
For McElroy, incomplete.
New Frank Warren. Oh, yeah. Stop it. Stop it.
Yeah. on the stop.
Stop it, Ford! That's the best!
Packing on!
CMR.
15 on it. Tack 15 on.
Tied up. One more play.
Flag on the play.
Yeah!
First down. Horizon. And the rush for 17. Bison, ball at the Rustler 17.
I think it really throw them off if they pass them.
And out to a dead. Tackled by Green that. And Knutson of the Rustlers.
And it was packed. I mean, you couldn't even move.
And heel holding.
He's got a pretty good foot.
Hiya!
First down, guys.
CMR will kick off.
Yeah!
Virginia. So the Rushmers brings up. Bison have to go before we present some awards. First of all, I think Jim Grant and principals tonight getting the kids ready. I'd like to give them a big round of applause. Great job. Many, many thanks to the cheerleaders, both squads. The bands did a great job. The drill teams, all the students, and the many great fans of Great Falls. Hats off to the fans of Great Falls. Great job.
Thank you.
Captain Thorne, Vicker, please come here. It's always tough in these great games to present these trophies because one gets gold and one gets silver. But I don't think you can ask of anything better from Great Falls High to come back and to do a great job in this game and representing Great Falls High is the principal Carol Johnson and the captains of the Great Falls Bisons. Great, great job. Congratulations on second team, on second place, double A. Congratulations, Bisons. And on behalf of the Montana High School Association, it's a great pleasure to present the trophy, the 1989 State Football AA Champions, CMR Rustler. Captain, please come to the table. Would the CM Russell captains please come to the awards table? Or a representative of the coaching staff? Or the fans? And before we present the trophy to the CM Russellers, I would just like to say that these trophies are presented and all of our awards, trophies, medallions, plaques by the Montana Power Company. There's not a a tremendous company in Montana's history and our future, and we'd like to thank them for the great commitment they've made to the youth of Montana. And with that, Pat Sherman presents the state championship trophy to the C.M. Russell Wrestler. Good job, Wrestler.
Feel.